In this video, we're looking at a force concept question that incorporates Newton's second law and Newton's third law. So the setup of the problem is that we have three blocks that are in contact on a smooth horizontal surface. In other words, we're going to neglect friction. And we have a force pushing to the right on this combination of blocks, causing them to accelerate. And we're going to find out how fast is the acceleration and what are all the contact forces between the blocks. So we're told in the problem that this force is 60 Newtons. And to answer this question about acceleration, well, all three of the blocks are accelerating at exactly the same rate because they're in contact the whole time. So we can just consider those to be a single collected 6 kilogram mass. So part A is actually really quick. I can write down Newton's second law. I'm just going to solve that for A and write that as F net over M. And we're talking about the X component here. I have a force pushing in the X direction, and that's the same as the direction of the acceleration. And my net force, well, there's only one of them. It's 60 Newtons. And the total mass is accelerating 6 kilograms. So we arrive at an acceleration of 10 meters per second squared. In the next part of the problem, we're asked to compute the magnitude of the contact force F12 between the 1 kilogram and 2 kilogram blocks. So what I'm going to do here is zoom in on the 1 kilogram block. And what we know about the 1 kilogram block is that it's accelerating at 10 meters per second squared. We just found that in part A. So we know the mass and we know the acceleration. And the reason this 1 kilogram block is accelerating is that the 2 kilogram block is pushing directly on it. So there's that force F12 pushing to the right on a 1 kilogram block, causing a 10 meter per second squared acceleration. So we just write down Newton's second law again. And again, it's a horizontal analysis, and we write down F net equals MA for the 1 kilogram mass. F net on this guy is just F12. It's the only force it feels. And the mass, that's 1 kilogram. And we observe an acceleration of 10 meters per second squared. And this means the contact force comes out to 10 Newtons. Next, we're going to look at the magnitude of the contact force F23 between the 2 and 3 kilogram blocks. And to get this done, we're going to group together the 2 kilogram and 1 kilogram blocks into a single 3 kilogram mass. That 3 kilograms is accelerating because it's being pushed on from the left by the 3 kilogram block being in contact with the 2 kilogram block. So we see that force F23 pushing to the right on this 3 kilogram combination. And this goes basically the same way that part B went. I have F net equals MA for this 3 kilogram collection of blocks. And the only force acting horizontally on that is F23 pushing to the right, the contact force from the 3 kilogram block, the total amount of mass being accelerated, 3 kilograms, the observed acceleration of these blocks, 10 meters per second squared, and we arrive at a contact force of 30 Newtons. So the question is answered, but there's actually a lot to learn by checking our answer. And the way I'm going to handle this is by analyzing all the forces on the 2 kilogram block. So we have the 3 kilogram block pushing to the right on the 2 kilogram block. And we just found out that has a magnitude of 30 Newtons and it points to the right. But there's a second force pushing on the 2 kilogram block. And we already figured this out in part B. We found out that the 2 kilogram block pushes to the right on the 1 kilogram block with a magnitude of 10 Newtons. Well, Newton's third law says that that 1 kilogram block better be pushing back to the left on the 2 kilogram block. So there's the reaction force of the 1 kilogram block pushing to the left on the 2 kilogram block. Now we can apply Newton's second law just to the 2 kilogram block. So we start with F net equals MA. And again, we're just looking at a horizontal analysis here. And my rightward force is 30 Newtons. My leftward force was 10 Newtons. So there's my net force, 30 Newtons minus 10 Newtons. And this is equal to the mass that we're looking at, 2 kilograms times the acceleration. So the check on our work here is to figure out what the acceleration is and make sure it's the same as what we got in part A. On the left-hand side, I get a net force of 20 Newtons. And this is equal to 2 kilograms times A. And we divide both sides by 2. And we find out that A is indeed 10 meters per second squared. And we're confident we've got everything right here. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.